Hey, this is Drew from Moon Audio, and I'm here to do a little special different thing than we normally do here at Moon Audio. I've got an interesting thing right here. And before I get into it, think about some of the really incredibly engineered products out in the world that you're really excited about. Let's say a Rolex watch, a high-end Ferrari, Porsche, BMW sports car. What is the most important thing about these things? It's the technology, it's the forethought into creativity to take engineering to the next level, right? That's what I want to explain a little bit about today. You know, a lot of things go into the creation of new audio products. You can do things half-assed ways, or you can take it to the limit. And I'm not saying there are tons of audio companies out there that do it half-assed, but the point that I'm trying to make is that you get what you pay for at the end of the day, right? You can buy a watch at Walmart for $5, or you can buy a Rolex watch for $20,000. They both tell time, but boy, that Rolex does it a whole lot sexier, am I right? So what we're talking about today is the Lina DAC. Hopefully you've seen my YouTube video where I went over the whole Lina stack system, how to use it, all the ins and outs. Today, we're gonna look more at the engineering, and essentially, this is what we're gonna call the Lina Exploded DAC, a Lina that can be deconstructed to show you all the incredible technology in terms of engineering feats that DCS has gone to create this product. So first, let's talk about the faceplate. Oh, I just took it off. So this entire faceplate was cut from an entire chunk of aluminum, okay? Now, this may seem simple, but they had to use a five-axis CNC cutting machine to not only do this, but cut up the rest of the pieces of this product, which is very complex and which is not typical for an audio company. They had to research and find partners that could really specialize into this sort of thing. So they went to go visit some aerospace and high-tech computer engineering companies to find the right people to help them create this amazing product. The backplate, again, solid chunk of aluminum that's machined down to create all these screw holes, all these holes, the different elevation planes, very complex. But wait, it gets even crazier. And hopefully this doesn't fall apart when I flip it because nothing's screwed together. Let me do this slowly and carefully. Let's first take off the bottom plate. And the bottom plate is what's used for holding on to, whoops, the power supply toroid. Again, solid chunk of aluminum that had to be drilled down all over the place, inside, outside, to create this perfect unison to fit everything together. DCS's transformers, I don't know if you can hear that or not hear that, are incredibly well potted. It's very important to pot these and to keep essentially vibration and noise out of your power supply. So this is dead silence. And the key, again, with all of this is silence, right? They're trying to create a dead quiet piece of marvelous technology. And to do that, and I'm gonna take off the next piece, and we've gotta be very careful that everything doesn't sort of explode. But watch this. Let me put that on its side so you can see that, and then I'm gonna get this out of the way. Another chunk of aluminum that they had to drill everything out of. Now look at this. Absolutely amazing. We've got connection points between each one of these PC boards. And typically you're using ribbon connecting cables or wire through the air to connect circuit boards. Well, DCS went to an incredible design approach to create a flexible circuit board is what they're calling it. So each one of these pieces here is transmitting electrical signals between boards to do different functions. But this is actually one PC board. These are not separate PC boards. There is no solder connection. There is no wire in here. It's part of the traces of the PC boards. This way they could create a PC board in a much smaller enclosure. You know, the whole goal of the DCS line was to make a headphone system. Well, headphone systems aren't typically 19-inch wide. You know, if we have the headphone amp 19 inches wide, the clock 19-inch wide, the DAC 19-inch wide, you know, all the size of the Bartok, it would be immense. To get all of this to fit together and to fold up and to work in all of these pieces of chassis and metal must have been an amazing feat. And as they said, it took 3 years to get this all designed, not just the electrical part, but to fold this together, fit it into a Faraday cage. And let me go back to this box again. A Faraday cage that comprises of this piece, the end caps, all of the other face plates, back plates, all of this to protect this unit from any outside interference, electromagnetic waves, any kind of vibration. They went to extreme lengths to make sure that this thing would be incredibly resonance-free and the best-sounding product on the market. They did a pretty damn good job with this. So what we've got here is, this is essentially part of the power supply design right here that's pulled from, obviously, the AC input over here. We're going through these hard connections here, which this is the flexible circuit board. Again, this is one circuit board. While it looks like we've got multiple circuit boards, they are all tied and fixed by these tabs. Traces are running from board to board, so this is one board essentially. So we've got here, this is our ring DAC here, where the magic happens, the ring DAC. We've got the output stage here that then goes to RCA and XLR outputs. This is our power supply components that ties around to the AC input. So we're pulling AC over here. It's going through the traces over to the power supply to power everything. We've got some of the front panel control stuff here. Here we've got the clocking situation. We've got two different crystals, one for 44.1, one for 48. Whatever the digital data rate that's coming in resides in one of these, okay? And when doing upsampling, you don't want to use the same crystal clock for both 44.1 and 48, so they separate it. This keeps the data clean, pure, and in its best format. They want to keep them in separate integers so that when they're doing upscaling, they're not using just one crystal, they're using the right crystal based on the data stream and the numbers. Here is your FPGA. The FPGA is used to control all of this. It's a highly programmable computer, essentially, where they do all their algorithms, where they do their firmware updates to do the Mosaic app to control everything. And as they make improvements, they can improve the sound quality and features of this product. You'll remember there have been two updates, some more cross-feed functions, if I remember right. Then number two came along. This added the digital volume control. So it's upgradable. That's a great thing about this DAC. I would imagine this is part of the network control here. Some more filtering and power supply here, maybe the power supply for the networking stuff. We want to keep things separate. Here is the main transformer. As I said, dead quiet, encapsulated, potted, extremely important because we're trying to keep noise down, not just in this. The whole thing is machined together to be one jigsaw puzzle and tied together with lots of screws to be very inert, very dead. Resonance is an issue in audio. This is technology at its finest. And I just want to show and explain you're getting what you're paying for. So hopefully I've showed you some fun things here about a DAC, a deconstructed DAC, which most people don't get to do with a DAC. This is really cool. Thank you, Emron from DCS, for sending this to me. It's so cool. I'm going to be studying this like crazy because I'm an engineering geek and I live for the inside part of these products other than the outside. Of course, the music and the sound is important, but I geek out on this because I'm an engineer and this is where I love to live. So hopefully you enjoyed taking a look at this. Make sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Leave any comments or questions about what goes on in the Lena DAC. Make sure to check out that YouTube video I did on the complete Lena stack so you can see how it works and how it sounds and all that stuff. Hope you've enjoyed taking a peek at the exploded view of the Lena, and we'll see you next time.